Ghana notion which says mathematics should be taught in vernacular for better understanding. So this week we will continue on the motion, but for the benefit of those that did not work last week, let's take a look at what happened last week.
A few weeks ago, my math teacher was on the topic latitude and longitude. We all seemed to understand when he said there were imaginary lines run across the surface of the earth. But without it being stressed and illustrated in our local language, we would have not been able to solve any calculations given us. As a typical acquirable mind, speaking the Bibi as a language, I can easily identify and define the lines of latitude to latitude to Rurafeke, Don Hufion, one Nasia, and longitude to Rurasanake, Don. And with this, I'm able to solve any calculations given me on that particular topic.
You know, it's impossible to produce different textbooks in various languages. It will cost resource consuming. Conflict in examination. Which particular local language do you expect to be used in setting wired system of examination? I strongly oppose the motion that mathematics should be taught in vernacular for a better understanding. Thank you.
6 divided by 3 gives us. Okay, bakano wita. Ama bakano wita. Only third time on Koi Baiba. I shall understand this better and faster.
So, my heart bleeds to hear from my opponents that a composite subject like mathematics should be taught in vernacular. When we all know that there are other subjects that have calculation in it, such as physics, chemistry, and even accounting, what would then be the fate of the students studying this subject? I leave that to the conscience of my opponents.
Yes, this week we'll continue on the motion. Second supporting speakers. And reply speakers as the lead speakers. I urge you to sit, relax, and experience the light. It promises to be very incisive. And our moderator once again is DMG Godfather Monday Job. Give it up to him as he comes.
Hello, viewer. You're once again welcome to another edition of Growing Up. My name is Godfather Monday Job. I hope you enjoyed yourself last week, because today's edition is a continuation of last week's edition, and we heard from the first supporting speaker and the lead speakers, and today we are going to continue from the second supporting speaker, and the topic is mathematics should be taught in vernacular for better understanding. And the proposition of the motion still remains Community Secondary Commercial School Ibiakuta, and on the opposition is Community Secondary Commercial School Ikorokubo, both schools in Akwa Ibom State. Please, a round of applause for this. Permit me to introduce the panel of judges. From my right, we have M.M. Usanga, Mr. Okun Ndem, and Antiga Hogan. I call on the timekeeper to give us the time permission guiding this debate.
Are you motivated?
Motivated, motivated, motivated.
Working in integrity.
Dignity for all.
Please listen to the time information. The second supporting speaker has 2 minutes. For the reply speech, the lead speakers have 2 minutes each to defend their school at best. The first bell means point of information should commence. The second bell means you have 1 minute left to conclude and point of information should end. The third and final bell means your time is up. Good luck.
Thank you, our accurate timekeeper. And now, I would urge you to listen to the chief judge of the panel.
Silence.
Superstars of tomorrow.
Silence.
Superstars of tomorrow.
Are we motivated?
Motivated, motivated, motivated.
Thank you, children, for being here again this week. The criteria for this event is very simple. Your appearance and your dressing will score you very well. The points you've raised, how you manage your time effectively, will equally contribute to your marks. Your grammar and tenses will add to your scores, and of course your pronunciation and diction will make you do very well. As you all know, this is a debate, so we want to hear you as clearly as possible. No distractions whatsoever. If you have any points that you want to raise as points of information, you should calmly pass that on a sheet of paper to the person next to you who will raise that on behalf of your school. So, if you adhere to this, you will do very well and you'll make your schools proud. Thank you very much.
I hope and believe that you will all adhere to the rules of the game, starting with the second supporting speaker from the proposing team.
Standing on the already existing protocol is Kesmin Achibo, a student of the Community Secondary Commercial School in Biakuntan. I am very elated to stand before this gathering in support of the motion that mathematics should be taught in vernacular for better understanding. Before I proceed, last week I heard my opponent say that students from different states, from different ethnics, will find it difficult to adapt to the language frame of that state. But I want to clearly state to you that it is not a difficult thing to do, because countries like Germany give people from different ethnics who go there to learn 1 year to learn their language before proceeding to learning. So I believe this can be adapted in other countries too. To start with, difficulties in understanding math questions. Many students in class do not have interest in math, and this lack of interest causes math failure in mathematics when it comes to understanding the questions. A question may tend to be simple, but it turns out to be difficult on the student's part due to the way the questions are twisted grammatically. This is because most children come from homes in which the mother tongue is the predominant language, resulting to early socialization. When math is taught in vernacular, the students will be able to understand. But when it is taught in English, they will only decode it. Teaching math in vernacular is no barrier to excellence, but will result to better understanding for the students. Second, the nature of math. English, according to Giovanni Tapa, may be the language of science, but students learn better and faster when taught in their local languages. Mathematics is not a subject that should be carelessly taught. One needs to follow every step in mathematics. And attempt to follow this step, any grammatical jargon that is not understood by the student makes the student less interested in it. Go on.
You earlier said that countries like India and Japan give a whole year for the stranger to adapt to the language. Mm-hmm. Don't you think that this period, what about the other students? They will progress to the other class. Don't you think this will lead to a setback or stagnation? And also, you mentioned that it will lead to a better understanding. How do you think, don't you think it will be more complicated as students in that particular class are not from the same ethnic group?
What I said earlier is not a problem. Because when they give 1 year to the language, it even helps, because it helps the person to know another language, and it gives credit to the person. So studies conducted by organizations such as UNESCO, World Bank, as well as local institutions show that students learn faster and better with enthusiasm when taught in their local language. Despite the prominence of English as a language of instruction, it is not a requisite for achieving excellence in mathematics. Every step in math should be explained in vernacular for every student to pick interest in it. Furthermore, economy boost. In the test in the trend in International Math and Science Study, TIMSS, carried out by the International Association for Evaluation of Educational Achievement, all have their basic instruction in their local language, with English integrated as only a part of a compulsory curriculum. These countries, Japan, Taiwan, Singapore, and South Korea, teach their education in their local language, with English integrated as only a part of a compulsory curriculum. Teaching math in vernacular not only enhances understanding for learners, but also paves way for more potential for national development. Finally, discouragement of dropout. Like I said earlier, many students come from homes in which their mother tongue is the predominant language. When there's a lot of grammar to the extent that the students do not even get to understand what the teacher is saying, this causes a lot of dropout due to lack of interest and understanding. Teaching math in vernacular makes for an interesting, a lively, and an interactive class. With this, I think I've been able to convince you, my listeners, that mathematics should be taught in vernacular for better understanding. Thank you.
That was interesting. Let's hear from you, the second supporting speaker from the opposing team.
I thought of hearing established protocol. My name is Samuel Debasi, representing Community Secondary Commercial School, Ikorokubo, Porto, Rio. I'm here to oppose the motion which says that mathematics should be taught in vernacular for better understanding with the following points. I overheard my teachers crying, weeping, because a mathematical seminar was organized and a teacher of commerce was taken in that state, only to discover that her godfather put her there. Even even ridiculous. How dare would this teacher impact on the students? This is an agent of corruption, Mr. Moderator, panel of judges, accurate timekeeper. I proceed. Money and resource consuming. Mr. Moderator, it is generally known that if mathematics is taught in vernacular, others will have to start from the scratch, and this might bring breakdown in the educational sector as teachers will not be concentrating in the new method of teaching math, different linguistic contexts. In Akwaibom, as we know, let me limit it there. In Akwaibom, as we know, has different ethnic groups such as Ibibio, Anam, Oro. And this might bring rise to different textbooks in which the students and the students may not even understand. How then would Ibibio speaking students in Oro learn? How will it learn? I would like to ask my opponent this question. How then would they perform an external examination? With these following points, I believe I'll be able to convince you beyond reasonable doubt that mathematics should not be taught in vernacular.
Thank you very much. And now we'll go on a short break, and when we are back, we'll listen to the reply speech from both schools.
It was my big sister's matriculation. Mom and Dad.
My.
We're so proud. And the party was quite ready. We all got a whiff of an unexpected guest.
There's a rumble in my tummy going boom bada boom bada boom. It means that I am hungry and me time is near. I am so excited that I can hardly wait. My mouth is getting ready to sing the Mimi song.
Take me, break me, any way you make me. Mimi, ooh, Mimi, ooh, ooh. Mimi, taste me, feel me.
There's more to me.
Produced by May and Baker.
Growing up, a debate special and unique.
Growing up, coming up every Sunday at 1:30 p.m. on NTA Channel 12, your dependable station. Growing up, raising young minds for the future.
What has this civilization really done? Civilization.
We have won for competition. We have won. You have won for competition. Have you won?
Every kid on earth would love to be a superstar. Every boy and girl would like to make it big. Come on, children, you know you're gonna get there. Just hold on to your dreams. Hold up, I'm gonna ready now.
Welcome back, it's still growing up. And it's time for the reply speech. But before that, for contribution, credible comments and sponsorship, you may like our Facebook page or you may call us on 080-6429-4907. I repeat, 080-6429-4907. Thank you very much. And now I'll call on Nelson Esther to please defend her team.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for the opportunity to bring me once more to buttress my argument. But before I proceed, let us sum up our stand in this debate. Last week, I heard my opponent talk about mathematics bringing this unity if taught in vernacular. I'll counter that point by using this example. Countries like Korea, India, and Germany, who spend 1 year in learning or studying their local language for effective participation in other teaching criteria, don't they relate well with their sister countries? Germany is one of the best engineering producing countries. They produce the warship that we're using now. But yes, they still use vernacular in learning Mathematics is a subject that has to be taught and learnt with passion. And without the love of it being involved, mass feeling is bound to be involved in it. However, we'll
need points of information.
Go on.
In Japan, like you said, you said they use vernacular. Well, I should tell you now, they use their national lingua franca and not vernacular. Thank you.
Before that, I was saying that mathematics is a subject that have to be taught and learned with passion. Without the love of it being involved, mass feeling is bound to be involved. I will evaluate my point by using late Mandela's famous quote, which says that if you speak to a man in the language he understands, you speak to his brain. But if you speak to a man in his own language, you speak to his heart. What have I said here today? That mathematics, when taught in vernacular, encourages mass participation, helps in breaking down concepts for easy understanding, and mathematics, therefore, is a subject of passion and has to be taught and nurtured with passion. With this point, therefore, I'm on grounds that the motion must stand, that mathematics should be taught in vernacular for easy understanding.
Please, a round of applause for her one. Should mathematics be taught in vernacular? It's time for the reply speech. So I'll call on the lead speaker from the opposing team, Glory Ofure.
I stand on the already established protocol to strongly and vividly oppose the motion that mathematics should be taught in vernacular for a better understanding. You mentioned countries like India and Japan. Do check their level of development. And you also said that mathematics should be taught in vernacular for a better understanding. If you say mathematics should be taught in vernacular, which we use at home for a better understanding in school, what then is the essence of education? What then is the essence of going to school at all in the first place? Dr. Chike Obi, the first doctor to obtain a doctorate degree in mathematics. Professor Eze Ilo, JOC, the first professor to obtain a degree in mathematics. And Dr. Williams Grace Adele, the first female to obtain a degree in mathematics. These are all great Nigeria students who are studying in various states and countries like Ibadan, Osun State, Chicago, Colombia, USA, to mention but a few. If vernacular was applied then, do you think they would have been able to move from one state or country to another in search of this great degree? I bet the answer is a capital no. This is so because the use of vernacular would have been a barrier to their quest for knowledge. If these ones, they are taught mathematics in English and they understood, how they can we say mathematics should be taught in vernacular for a better understanding? If we say mathematics should be taught in vernacular for a better understanding, does it not then mean that this generation are students without head and brain?
Don't you think that this language, this country, language-speaking countries, like the Germany, for example, are more advanced than we do scientifically, intellectually, because they learn mathematics in vernacular?
The answer is no, because they are minorities. Most of them are minorities. They don't have different ethnic groups as Nigeria do. So they can easily use their own. They can easily use their local language. Wait. The moderator said, for a better understanding of the subject, mathematics, students should be provided with well and conducive environment, good textbook, well-trained and friendly teachers, and not that the subject should be taught in vernacular. And also, seminars and enlightenment programs should be organized for the teachers of mathematics, and not that this great subject should be taught in vernacular, because it will lead to a great fall in this subject.
One of your speakers said that teaching mathematics in vernacular will consume money. Are you trying to tell me that if mathematics is taught in vernacular in Nigeria, that it will consume money because it is an English-speaking country?
It will consume money because it is money that you will go and use to restart writing mathematics in vernacular. As I was saying, one of the aims of education is to encourage discipline. So mathematics should not be taught in vernacular because it will lead to class mismanagement. I hope with all these points I'll be able to convince all present that mathematics taught in vernacular will never lead to a better understanding.
And this is the moment we all have been waiting for. Should mathematics be taught in vernacular? Some say mathematics is difficult, while others say it is easy. Anyway, just keep solving. And now I hand it over to the panel of judges for announcement of results.
Thank you very much, children, for an incisive outing. I must comment that I learned a great deal. Maybe if I were taught mathematics in vernacular, I wouldn't be scared the way I am. I must confess that the only mathematics formula I know is if I buy, I know the amount of money that should come back to me. But it's fun watching you and knowing that you've been able to stretch your minds to actually see into the future, a situation that Nigeria can change. And I want to find out if my panel here, if anybody has anything to add to what the children said today.
In every competition, there is always a winner. So whoever is the winner today, the other school shouldn't feel that they did not perform very well. Both schools did excellently well. Thank you.
We have seen outstanding talent showing from both schools.
Yeah.
Even among the lead speakers and the supporting speakers, and even the backup people, we have seen talent, and even people who are aspiring to speak, maybe next time they will give them a chance to represent their school. So it has been a wonderful performance. We want to encourage you to continue from there. Thank you.
Yes. As with the tradition of this debate, we will announce the results. But before we do that, may we quickly recognize the efforts of two people that distinguished themselves today. And for the very first time, we will be presenting certificate to the most valuable speaker. And the reason is simple. The level of comportment, composition, every speech she made landed at the appropriate time, and that person is no other than Precious Okun. Please, may Nelson Esther Jerry also join us as the best speaker for the day.
Congratulations.
Okay, and now to the results proper. As we saw today, the contest was a very keen one, and all the students made us feel their presence. They told us why mathematics should be and should not be taught in vernacular. Well, the results here shows that community secondary commercial school Ibiakwitam scored 313 points. While community secondary commercial school Ikorokubo Ford scored 304 points. And so with that result, community secondary commercial school Ibiakwitam has been declared the winner of today's contest. And they automatically proceed to the next round of this competition. Thank you very much. According to the winning school, mathematics should be taught with the vernacular. Well, I think those who are responsible have watched this program and they know exactly what to do. At this time, let me invite students of Community Secondary Commercial School Ibiakwitam, the winner of today's contest, to receive their trophy.
Together for the success of this company.
thank you for coming on the program. And you are out there, I hope you've learned a lot on today's package. If so, why not keep a date with us next week, same station, when we shall be coming your way with another educated topic. But until then, remember, keep practicing mathematics because
mathematics is a very simple subject.
Bye. Bye.